sailors' tales to sailors' tunes, storm and adventure, heat and cold, if schooners, islands, and maroons and buccaneers and buried gold, and all the old romance retold exactly in the ancient way, can please as me they pleased of old, the wiser youngsters of today. So be it. Ha-ha! And fall off!
My name is Jim Hawkins. This island of Portobello is my home. Most people would say it's not a fit place to bring up a young English lad of gentle breeding, but if you'll take a boy's word for it, Portobello is the most wonderful place in the whole world. Where else would you find a town whose every other citizen is a pirate? Yes, I know. Decent folk throw up their hands at mention of the words pirate or buccaneer. But I don't find all pirates are bad. Some of them are just different from folks who get up and go to bed and eat their meals in safety their whole lives. Long John Silver is a pirate. He is also my guardian. People find this hard to believe, but I tell them Long John is good. You needn't take just my word for it. Sir Henry Strong, governor of Portobello, must feel the same way, or he never would have put me in Long John's custody. The governor wasn't too sure about it at first, but when he remembered how Long John had saved my life, he gave in. Anyhow, he wasn't just turning me over to Long John alone. My other guardian is Miss Purity Pinker. She owns the Cask and Anchor Tavern. I live at the Cask and Anchor. Miss Purity sees that I wash behind my ears, mends the tears in my breeches, and makes me go to school.
A happy birthday to you. A happy birthday to you. A happy birthday, dear Elizabeth. A happy birthday to you.
Now you must cut the cake, Elizabeth.
Thank you, Cedric. Please help me, Jim.
Happy, my Jim! Imagine helping the governor's daughter cut her birthday cake.
My dear Lady Mary, who is that woman? I'm told she's a tavern keeper at Government House. And that is her brat with Elizabeth. One would never have guessed.
My dear, blood will out.
London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady.
Why don't you come and play with me?
I don't want to.
Oh, come on.
No. Oh, let me go.
London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady.
My poor Cedric.
Such vulgar boisterousness.
I shall forbid Cedric to play here in future.
London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady.
Charming party, Your Excellency.
Charming.
I'm so glad you think so. You sit alone, Miss Pinker?
I'd be enjoying every minute of it, Your Ladyship.
But you must not sit alone. Mrs. Featherston Hall, Lady Mary, may I introduce Miss Purity Pinker?
How do you do?
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Will you not sit by us, Miss Pinker?
Thank you kindly. Thank you. Did you ever see such a spread of food in your whole life? It must have cost a proper fortune. All them glasses and plates and such. Ah, the poor little lamb. Do you suppose it's the liver that makes them look like that? If I was his mother, I'd give the poor lad a good dose of castor oil. That'd fetch him.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for asking us, your ladyship.
There's to be a boating party tomorrow. Will you allow Jim to come?
Tomorrow?
Oh, may I, Miss Purity?
Aye, Jim. Thanks again, Lady Strong.
Then the carriage will call for Jim at 9, Miss Pinker. I should be grateful, though, if you could arrange to have him fetched home.
What time would suit?
Why, after supper, I think.
Aye.
Wasn't it a wonderful party, Miss
Purity? Aye. It brought to mind me own birthdays when I was a child. Not as grand as Miss Elizabeth's, but always the cake and the singing of happy birthdays. It took me back over the years, Jim. The sweetmeats, the syrupy drinks, the giving of presents.
Why should it make you so sad?
Such hopes as one has as a child. And now, as the years roll on and birthdays come, nobody cares.
Miss Purity, it's the Reverend Minister.
Hi.
May I offer you a lift back to the tavern, Miss Pinker?
Thank you, Reverend. Did you enjoy the party?
I saw very little of it. Parish duties keep me busy night as well as day.
Oh, you be a proper saint, your reverend. Visiting the sick and the poor, hail, rain, or shine.
Come on.
I'd be the same way myself. Fall asleep in the twinkling of an eye on me father's shoulder. Ah, oh, such nonsense as a birthday party puts into me head. How's the Widow Fife, Reverend?
Oh, poorly. I haven't visited her since yesterday.
Ah, yes. You've many calls on your time.
More than one man can cope with, however willing.
Would I come along and lend a hand should the need arise?
You would be more than welcome, Miss Purity. The Widow Fife must be my first call tomorrow.
Tomorrow? My birthday.
Bless my soul, so it is.
Ah, you remembered.
March 16th, of course, of course. I shall try to find time to call in tomorrow morning and wish you a very happy day.
Ah, thank you, Reverend. I wonder who else will remember my birthday. Come along, Jim.
Here, Patch. We'll need extra anchor overboard. Here, you shove off. That near amber has a big fall in tide. We'll weigh anchor at dawn. Here comes Purity. Jim, lad. You be out here bunk late tonight.
I've been to a party at Government House. Elizabeth's birthday.
Here, take a look at the Duchess. Her, so you be hobnobbing with the gentry, Abby.
Better than ye could do. Look at the cut of you in your greasy rags, wallowing like a pig in swill. Jim's been up to Government House, mixing with all those fine little ladies and gents, and then coming back to this.
Oh, belay, a sailor likes to make himself at home.
Come along, Jim. It's time you were in bed, or you'll be dropping in your tracks. Having nightmares, no doubt, after all that rich food.
It was wonderful, Long John. I wish you could have been there.
Oh, a fine show he'd make of himself in such company.
Our Purity is right. I'm no good at birthdays and such frivolities. Besides, I have more important things on my mind.
That's plain to be seen indeed.
Patch and I have a scheme, Atchin. The faithful sails at dawn tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Aye. So it'll be goodbye for a while instead of good night, Jim.
Oh, you wouldn't be putting to sea tomorrow.
I tell you, we've a scheme afoot.
It's all planned, Miss Purity.
Besides, I've left here before without warning.
Indeed you have. It's not the first time, Silver, but by Flynn's body and bones, it'll be the last. I'd be right sick of your selfish ways. You come and go as you please, and never a thought or a feeling for them you leave behind. You're thinking nothing but... Oh, go and don't come back.
What's the matter with her, Long John? I think she was crying.
Ah, she'll get over it. Let a woman have her way in a matter of business and she'll have you hog-tied. Now off to bed with you, lad.
Aye, Long John.
Patch, round up the rest of the crew. I don't want half of them adrift when I sets foot aboard in the morning. Aye, Captain.
Purity on her birthday from father.
Birthday.
Looks like it.
This be a special day, Iron Hand.
What be special about it?
Small chance I've got to slumber a bed with the likes of lazy good-for-nothings like you to watch. You're late. Get to work.
Miss Purity.
across the bar this morning from my window.
The commons and gone to that one-legged ruffian be nothing to me. Selfish and heartless he be. I be finished with Long John Silver forever.
But why?
Sailing today of all days.
What's so special about today, Miss Purity?
You've not washed behind your ears. Now upstairs and do it proper.
From my own garden with the dew still on them. Ah, my dear, dear Miss Purity.
You were the first and only one to wish me happy birthday.
Did you tell them it was your birthday?
It was for them to remember.
Jim? Long John?
Oh, that swivel-tongued swab. Oh, begging your pardon, your reverence. He sailed this morning, the first thing on some old villainous voyage.
And did you tell them that...
Without even remembering.
Oh, shame on him. And I would have vowed that his regard to your good self, Miss Purity, was Long John's redeeming feature. It's a bad thing for you to sit and mope away your birthday. Will you not accompany me on my visiting?
Well,
there is no balm-like service to others, and I should be most grateful for your help.
Well, I...
Now, why don't you close down the tavern for the day? The girls can have a holiday.
That's right. It'll make it a special day, even if they don't know why. I'll go and change my dress. Oh, thank you, Reverend.
I'm all ready, Miss Purity.
I've asked the girls to wait to see you safely in the Government House carriage.
May I hang out the sign?
Aye. Now, the Reverend Monaster will call for you this evening.
Why don't you wear your pretty party hat?
Oh, today I be headed for a hard day's labor, Jim.
You looked so elegant in it last night, Miss Purity. I was proud of you.
Oh, sure, it be seasons old, lad. I've not the heart to buy a new one. Hang out the sign. Get clean, don't you? Oh, now close your eyes. Here we go. Go on around. Oh, that's a little lamb. Oh, how lovely you look now. That's right. Keep your eyes closed. You won't get any soap in them.
Doctor.
Nothing yet? Perhaps the doctor may not come in time.
Then I must do the job myself.
You are a fine woman, Miss Purity. Not another in Portobello would have given this day of all days to the service of others.
What better way to celebrate? Fancy now. Here I am on my birthday, waiting for a little child to be born. It'll be my godchild for sure, the little darling.
I hope it will be soon, sir. Oh, you must try to relax, Mr. Watts.
Relax?
Fathers are made every minute of the day, my son. And they generally survive. And Mary brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them at the inn. And they were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around upon them, and... Oh, Miss Purity will call you, my son, when it's time.
You've been like an angel from heaven.
He be a fine bonny boy. You should rest now.
Please, fetch my husband.
Aye.
I must take you home, Miss Purity.
It must be late, and I've quite forgotten about poor Jim.
Oh, I called by and explained to Lady Strong. She said she would take care of the boy until we come.
Two such late nights. Hi, the tavern be in darkness.
Without doubt, the scullery maids are abed.
Look, in the tavern.
I see nothing.
There are lights flickering like a torch.
Oh, you must be tired imagining things.
But there it goes again.
I see nothing.
I did. A torchlight. It flickered, then went out.
Thieves.
Your mace or iron hand.
I tell you, there'll be thieves in the tavern.
Do you really think so?
No, no.
If I had a musket, I'd tackle them myself.
What are you trying to do?
Fetch the watch.
I'll come with you.
But there might be bloodshed, the soldiers.
There will be bloodshed. You best stay here, Your Reverence.
We three of us can investigate first.
I'll not have you mixed up in a brawl, nor Jim either.
I'll be all right, Purity.
You'd get hurt, and the Reverend's life is too precious to the community. I'll fetch the soldiers and we'll take them red-handed.
Miss Purity, no, no!
Ivy Purity, take her of the cask and anchor.
It's been closed up all day with the sign outside.
We just saw torches inside.
Thieves!
Desperate cutthroats, without a doubt. The scum of the earth be washed up around this quarter. What ails you, Reverend?
I'm sure there's nothing amiss at the tavern.
We came down here to investigate reports of strange activity going on. Approach quietly. Cover the windows. I'll take the door.
And kill them.
Oh, Long John, I thought you were thieves. You darling man. I never doubted you would remember.
Is it your...
Since you're here, come in and join us.
Reverend Manasta, now you knew about this all the time you roamed. And Long John, why did you cause me such heartache, sailing away this dawn like a base deserter?
Well now, Purity, I had an errand to do in Jamaica, buying your birthday present. Iron Ann. There.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Made by the finest hatter in the Indies.
21 candles. All long, John.
Now you can help me blow them out!